students. Previous class we are discussing about the coordination life process. Some topic is completed. Now we are going to discuss the next topic. In this topic, today we are discussing the activity. Which activity? Like a sugar crystals over that time. Now we observe the how we are eating the food with the help of the tongue and teeth. Directly we are eating the food at the time we are identifying the taste? No. That's why we observe the a small activity. You take the sugar crystals. You take the sugar crystals, place on our tongue. At that time, open your mouth and place the sugar crystals on the tongue. Immediately you observe the time. Or you take the stopwatch. How much time you are identify the taste. Identify the time. In the same way, now you take the crystals on tongue and immediately press against our palate. You identify the this time. How much time is required for identification of the taste. You take the sugar solution on that time. Then also you identify that time. So in these three activities, first we are taking the sugar crystals, or open the mouth and take our tongue and keep the crystals on that time, not attached to the palate. On that time, how much time is required to identify the taste? Second time, you identify the taste with the help of the against the palate. The sugar crystals keep on the tongue and press against the palate. And third one, you identify the like a sugar solution keep on that time. So these three activities we identify the different timings. When we press the against the palate, on that time only you identify the easy manner the our taste. So that's why here we identify the sugar crystals taste immediately means press against the palate. So in this one we identify the tastes means different parts are present. First one, we any food item we take only the that is the good smell or bad smell through the nose. So that's why here we identify with the nose. Our nose contains the here olfactory receptors. So olfactory receptors are present in the nose, and after we are taking the food through the mouth. Our mouth contains the salivary glands. And after we identify the like a tongue is present in the mouth. On that time, they contain the taste buds. So, first when we are tasting the food, only identify the smell. So, here nose identify the smell through the olfactory receptors. After we have tasted the food through the mouth, mouth contains the salivary glands. After the help of the tongue, so tongue identify the tastes with the help of the taste buds. These all are like a taste buds, salivary glands, olfactory receptors. How is the send the brain? After brain analyze and they give the which type of taste. So in this manner we identify the taste of the food. So here very very important things. All parts are involved, like the identification of the soil. So this is the one activity is given in our material, and after we identify the how the like a mouth is like a munching machine. Mouth act as a munching machine. How? Like a different types of teeth are present in our mouth. So these all the teeth are working together. Like a first one, when we observe the our mouth contains the different types of teeth. So here the different types of teeth. One is the like a incisors. And second one, canines. Canines. Third one, premolars. Fourth one, molars. These are the different types of teeth that are present in our mouth. Now you observe the teeth in the mouth, like a different shapes also present in this teeth. Like this is you observe the lower jaw. We have the upper jaw and the lower jaw. You know very well. Upper jaw is not mobile. It is usually the skull, and lower jaw is only the mobile. So that's why when we observe the lower jaw, so these are the half of the structure is right here. Like a our fifth gradient done. How occur the taste? the mouth. With the help of the salivary glands, no one uses like a, the solid taste of the food particles is not identified the easy manner. When the food is converted into the liquid form, then only identify the easy. That's why here the salivary glands produce the saliva. The saliva is mixed with the, our food material, they identify the taste. Not only the identification, here some digestion process also occurs in the mouth with the help of the salivary amylase. That's why here we identify the how act the saliva on the food. That's why we identify the saliva like you take the test tube. At the same way, you take some fluid. First of all, you take the two test tubes filled with the, like a one test tube filled with water. After you add some fluid, mix with the water very well. After the fluid water is present, or starch solution, don't need to take any starch, that means BMPT like that. So after the mixture, that means water, the solution, you take same quantities in the two test tubes. Now we identify the like a here the starch is present or not, we know how like a iodine test. That's why we are taking the flour or starch or not, you pour some iodine in the test tubes, immediately the convert the color. So that's why we are taking the starch solution. Okay. Now you divide the starch solution the two test tubes. You add some saliva in the one test tube. You take your saliva in the one spoon and add our starch solution. And another test tube, no need adding up the saliva. After some time, you observe which one is converted the colors. Like which one is added like our saliva, that is converted into the some color. So that's why our food is digested with the help of the saliva. So saliva contains a special enzyme. The enzyme act on the starch. This is the very important one activity. Okay, so we'll continue the next activity in the next class.